last night. First shift of the game, Mathieu Joseph right in front of the Oilers bench got away with a clear interference on the Edmonton Oilers' Ryan Nugent-Hopkins. Okay, there is about three, what we've seen here, and here's the thing, if you're watching the game on TV, and most of you are watching the games on TV, as a lot of the knowledgeable hockey guys out there realize, as good as the television coverage is, you don't necessarily see all the backside interference stuff. And look, we have some really intelligent people that text the show and listen to the show and care about the product and all that sort of stuff. Allow me to suggest to you, over the course of the last 2 weeks, we've seen the whistles get put away on interference. And the Lightning had a couple guys last night in Mathieu Joseph, Cedric Paquette, that were finishing hits after pucks had been passed off, that were interfering, angling off. Joseph got a piece of Nugent Hopkins on the first shift, raced across the ice, hopped inside and low-bridged Connor McDavid on the second shift of the game, which was surprising because I didn't see that sort of game from Mathieu Joseph when I recall him being on the World Junior team the 1 year. And then, of course, in the third period, he hit Chris Russell from behind, and Jujhar Khaira and Zach Cassian both requested that they honor him and square up and fight. And he didn't take the fight. So Milan Lucic looked at the game, 5-2 game, you know, looked at the situation and said, I'm going to assume, you know, I got to send a message here. And so, Joe, and for those of you that naively believe Joseph didn't know what was coming, come on, man. Be smarter than that. Absolutely, he knew what was coming. Okay? You can't play the game as greasily as Mathieu Joseph did and not expect something to come your way. And so Lucic got a good piece out of him and then gave him a little face wash, and that's that. I would argue that Mathieu Joseph is lucky this wasn't 10 years ago because he probably would have been popped with the glove off. But if you're going to play that way, you're going to bear the responsibility. Three things needed to happen for that to stop. Number one, the officials, and this is becoming an ongoing trend, they call a lot of penalties early in the year. They stop calling interference penalties. Again, when you're in the building, many of you would have seen McDavid come down the left side of the ice in the first period. Obviously, clearly, there was an infraction that they completely missed. He was basically tackled on the play, no call. Well, there was two or three other ones like that even before that, behind the scenes where they're sitting there hooking and grabbing. The only explanation I have for it is that Connor McDavid moves so fast that the officials aren't in good enough position to make the calls. Because surely it can't be because the officials don't want to make the calls. But when the officials don't police the game, and then when Joseph goes and boards, that's a boarding penalty. Milan Lucic earlier this season got a penalty for hitting a guy too hard. It wasn't even boarding. Yes, the referee told him, you hit him too hard, so I called a penalty. So when you board Chris Russell, right now there's 600 guys at Edmonton playing men's league hockey that know damn well if you hit a guy, and sometimes guys get hit in men's league, it happens. You hit a guy, you better be prepared to be accountable. So Mathieu Joseph goes and drills Chris Russell, has two guys on the ice challenge him, and he doesn't take the fight. I watched Doug Gilmour square up once with Stu Grimson. Please tell me that Mathieu Joseph couldn't take that battle against either Khaira or Cassian. If that had happened, nothing would have occurred. So Lucic sent a little message. It happens.